Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading Scripture of St. Martin, Volume 1, which we found right here in the Cathedral of St. Martin. The Scripture of St. Martin, Volume 1, The Life of St. Martin, a text written on behalf of the Church of St. Martin by High Priest Nerimus Agrician. Foreword. I bid you humble welcome, dear reader, as you read this text and begin your journey into the life of St. Martin Septim. The Scripture of St. Martin is divided into two distinct volumes, Volume 1, The Life of St. Martin, and Volume 2, Teachings of the Church. I bid you study each of these separate portions of the text carefully to aid you in the spiritual journey upon which you are about to embark. This, the first volume of the Scripture, retells the thrilling and sobering life led by Martin Septim, leading up to his rise to sainthood and his critically important background enabling followers of St. Martin to understand the context from which its teachings are born. I thank and commend you for your interest in the teachings of St. Martin. High Priest Nerimus Agrician. The Life of St. Martin Septim. The life of St. Martin began humbly, born simply as Martin, the priest of the Chapel of Akatosh in the city of Kavach. On more particular note, however, was his youthful practicing of the foul art of Daedra worship. Yes, dear reader, 'tis true, your eyes do not deceive you. St. Martin worshipped the infernal Daedra. Let this not dissuade you from your reverence of him, however, for this was but a fleeting portion of his life, a dark path that he soon abandoned in pursuit of nobler gods and, eventually, a much nobler cause. For it must be said, dear friend, that the city of Kavach did fall under dreadful Daedric siege. The Oblivion Crisis, sweeping across all Tamriel, did not spare St. Martin's home from its devastation. No special pardon was granted to this bustling metropolis merely due to its most extraordinary inhabitant. Yet, amidst the chaos, St. Martin Septim did not falter. He led numerous civilians to safety in the chapel, barricading themselves within, securing them brief sanctuary from the Daedric Horde. And it was here, dear friend, that Martin Septim was discovered by the fabled champion of Cyrodiil and informed that he was the son of Emperor Uriel Septim VII, and therefore the last true heir to the Ruby Throne, and by extension, the Empire itself. And so, dear friend, Martin Septim rode with the Champion of Cyrodiil to the fabled Blades Fortress of Cloud Ruler Temple to begin their holy war against the vile Daedric Prince Maroons Dagon and his wicked mortal servants, the mythic Dawn Cult. And 'tis true also, friend, that Saint Martin, along with the Champion of Cyrodiil, designed and executed a great many schemes that led the cult to falter. Most notably, among them, the Battle of Bruma, in which the Mythic Dawn were lured into opening a great gate, a particularly powerful Oblivion Gate, to aid in their assault of the city, enabling the Champion of Cyrodiil, Martin's greatest agent, to secure a great sigil stone, an artifact of immense power needed for Martin's plan. The Champion of Cyrodiil rushed into the gate as Martin stalwartly slaughtered countless Daedra on the battlefield. And as the Champion of Cyrodiil emerged from the now-ruined Oblivion Portal with the Great Sigil Stone in hand, it became clear to the world that Martin Septim was the true heir to the Ruby Throne, and the Champion of Cyrodiil a true hero to the world. And so it was that Martin Septim, employing the power of the Great Sigil Stone and destroying numerous other infernal Daedric artifacts, opened a portal to the false paradise created by Mancor Camorin, the leader of the Mythic Dawn Cult, and the Champion of Cyrodiil entered, and Mancor Camorin was slain within his idolatrous and fetid home, and the leader of the cult lay there lifeless. And it was so that Martin rode with the Champion from Crowd Ruler Temple to the Temple of the One in the Imperial City to light the dragon fires and restore the ward between Tamriel and the vile hosts of Oblivion. And it was indeed so that Maroons Dagon, in a final attempt to corrupt and destroy the world, manifested within the city itself. Martin Septim then, faced with the realization that it was too late to light the dragon fires by conventional means, made a quick, bold, and just decision. And yes, dear friends, he took the Amulet of Kings and sundered it, transforming himself into a flaming, holy, dragon-like avatar of Akatosh. and it was here that Martin Septim, in this bold and divine form, slew the manifestation of the wretched prince and ended the Oblivion Crisis. And Martin then rested for all eternity, and his avatar turned to stone and became a statue in the Temple of the One. And all Tamriel was saved from corruption, and Martin rose to sainthood. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim, Scripture of Saint Martin, Volume 1.